We talk a lot about how our movies are grounded and how they're based in the real world, which is not really true. They're based in the Marvel world, whether it's being bit by a spider or gamma, getting hit by gamma radiation or cosmic radiation, or being stuck in a cave and building a big iron suit. Not the real world. What's real about it are the character interactions and the emotions. That's what resonates as being real. When characters respond to situations the way one would. When they're thrust into overwhelming situations and can't just deal with it very easily, when their trials and tribulations to overcome, just like all of us deal with all the time, that's what's real, that's what's relatable. This is an origin story for Thor. It's not about getting powers, it's about learning how to deal with those powers. It's about going from the petulant son or the prince to more of a noble hero, to understanding what that means. And in the origin, and again, the brilliance of the early comics, his origin was Odin banishing him to Earth. His origin was Odin saying, you haven't learned, you're too pompous, you're taking everything for granted, you think that you're just a big golden child who can use his significant strength to muscle people around. It doesn't work that way. Odin has his own issues, but he's wise and he's much older. And he realizes he has to take a drastic measure and banishes his son out of Asgard down to Earth. Which, as far as Thor is concerned, is not a great place to be. They don't know who he is. They have no respect for him. They've forgotten that they've ever existed. He's not going to get by on his name or who his father is on Earth. And in fact, Odin takes away his hammer. He takes away his powers. And Thor is left in the worst situation possible for somebody as pompous and egotistical as he is at the start of our movie. Without his powers, in a place where nobody knows or even cares who he is. That was what was brilliant about that origin story, about taking to Earth. The story is about growth, is about maturity, and we needed somebody that could go on both sides of that. And we read a lot of people, dozens and dozens of people. Did a screen test with 4 or 5 people. And Chris Hemsworth kept coming up again and kept coming back and kept coming back. And he worked really hard, and Ken started sitting down with him and working. And by the end, it came, you know, it started with us going, here's this wide array, we don't know who it's going to be. And at the end, there was no question that it was going to be Chris. You can't help but watch him. He has a presence. He's got a humor about him. He can deliver these lines, which are very grand, in a way that you believe, and in a way that you feel for him, and you want to know what happens to him next. You care about him. And it really is the best of what makes somebody watchable, what makes that movie star quality. And we wanted Jane Foster, the most famous early love of Thor in the comics, to be a part of that, and to be a part of his origin story as she was in the comics. So we thought, let's update her, let's make her a part of this team, that she is a doctor, perhaps went to medical school, but instead found much more interest in the sciences. And we wanted to find somebody who you would at one time be beautiful and fit that mold of being the love interest for a superhero, but at the same time, who you would believe is that intelligent and is that smart and can go toe-to-toe with every other character in the movie, and in fact, can sort of lead to a grand discovery of what and who Thor is. And very early on, unlike the list of people, unlike lots of auditions, we started saying, you know, we need to get somebody like Natalie Portman, who is just beautiful and who is incredibly smart, and you believe it. That's right, that's good. Who could it be? Who could it be that somebody like this has that Natalie Portman quality? And of course, some genius at one point went, how about we ask her? I thought, well, God, we could do that. I guess we could. Let's find out. Thankfully, she likes this genre. She likes Marvel. More importantly, she's a huge fan of Ken Branagh and really wanted to work with Ken. And she and Ken had a number of great, great meetings in which she talked about, this is not the damsel in distress. This is, you're not going to be tied to the train tracks. You're going to be the prime motivator of Thor's entire transformation over the course of the film. And he gave her a lot of science books, which I think she probably read that night. And we were very lucky to get her. She's a great part of the ensemble.